Welcome students. Today we are going to start with a new chapter on ultrasonics. This is a very interesting chapter and a practical application based chapter. Okay, so this is a chapter from unit 1. This is the second chapter in our syllabus. So what is ultrasonics? So ultrasonics are basically sound waves. Okay, only thing that we cannot hear them. So that's why they are called as ultrasonics. So basically, to understand what ultrasonics, let us first start with some few basics about sound. What is sound and a few features about sound. Okay, so what is sound? Sound, we all know, is a vibration. All vibrating objects produce sound. So for example, when you hear a bell ringing, what is happening actually over there? The bell is actually vibrating. If you touch the surface of the bell, you will see the vibrations in the bell. Moment you touch the bell, the vibrations will stop and the sound also stops. Okay, so rather any sound which we hear, any sound which we can listen, is always produced by some object which is vibrating. Another example could be a tuning fork. Suppose you strike a tuning fork and you bring it close to your ear, you will hear the vibrations. Okay, you hear a vibration, the tuning fork, you can't see the vibrations there, but you can feel the vibrations. If you touch the prongs of the tuning fork, you will be able to feel the vibrations. And if you hold the tuning fork tightly, the vibrations will be stopped and the sound also will stop. So, also if you touch your vocal cords, okay, if you touch your throat as you're talking, you will feel some vibrations there. So, how do we produce sound? The vocal cords, when we blow air over them, they vibrate and that's how they produce sound. So, the general thing is that all sounds are produced by vibrating objects. Mosquitoes, bees also produce sound. Mosquitoes and bees. But how do they produce sound? Not with their mouth, but with the flapping of their wings. So when the wings vibrate up and down, that is how the sound gets created. So, next thing about sound is that sound is a longitudinal wave. There are two types of waves. Waves you can classify into two types. Longitudinal and transverse. Sound is a longitudinal wave, wherein the vibrations occur in the same direction as the propagation of the wave. So as the wave, suppose I'm talking here, the wave is moving away from me, the vibrations of the medium also occur back and forth, to and fro, in the same direction, parallel to the direction in which the wave is propagating. So sound is a longitudinal wave. So it travels in the form of alternate compressions and rarefactions. So as the sound is being produced, the layer of air which is closest to the object which is vibrating gets compressed. Okay, so this layer in turn pushes another, further layer compresses, and the first layer rarefies. So the next layer which is compressed again further compresses the next further layer of air, and that's how the sound propagates, in the form of compressions and rarefactions. Compressions, rarefactions, compressions, rarefactions. So a few properties about sound. Sound cannot travel in vacuum. Sound always requires a medium to travel. Okay, so the speed of sound depends upon the medium in which the sound is traveling. Okay, sound can travel fastest in a more denser medium. So in solids, sound can travel the fastest. Then in liquids, it is a little bit slower. And in air or any gaseous medium, it is the slowest. And in vacuum, as we know, sound cannot travel in vacuum. So the speed of sound in vacuum is zero. What about the speed of sound in air? This is an important constant which will be better if you know it. Okay, so in air, sound travels with a speed of around 340 meters per second. Compare this with the velocity of light. Velocity of light in air is about 3 into 10 raised to 8 kilometers per second. Okay, 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second. So it's a very large amount of speed. So compared to light, the speed of sound, 340 meters per second, is a very small amount. So light, the speed of light is very huge compared to the speed of sound. Now, two things about sound we need to know. What is meant by frequency? Another thing is what is meant by amplitude of sound. These are two important parameters, and they are two different parameters about sound. What do you mean by frequency of sound? Frequency, another word for it is called as pitch. Pitch of the sound. So it is how many vibrations are occurring per second. So as I told you earlier, sound is produced by a vibrating object. So what is the frequency of the sound produced by a vibrating object? it is the same as the frequency of the vibrations of that object. Suppose an object is vibrating, let us say, 100 times in a second. 100 times in a second, it is expanding, contracting, expanding, contracting. So this is called vibrations in and out motion. So let us say 100 times in a second, the object is going in and out, vibrating. So the what sound will it produce? What is the frequency of the sound the object will produce? It will produce a sound of frequency 100 hertz. Okay. So mosquitoes, for example, mosquitoes, they flap their wings about 500 times in a second up and down. Okay. So the frequency of sound produced by a mosquito is about 500 hertz. Suppose we have a tuning fork. Suppose we have a tuning fork which has a number on it, 396 hertz, like that, as you can see in the figure there. 396 hertz. What does it mean? If you strike this tuning fork, the prongs will vibrate at a rate of 396 times per second, and it will produce a sound of frequency 396 hertz. So, what is the general thing? The frequency of sound is the same as the frequency of the object which is vibrating. Okay, the rate at which the object is vibrating, the sound produced by that object will have the same frequency as the frequency of its vibration. Amplitude of sound is something different. Amplitude of sound tells you how loud the sound is. It talks about the loudness, the size, the amplitude of the wave. Okay, so it's different from frequency. So frequency is how many vibrations are occurring per second in that sound wave, whereas amplitude of a sound wave tells you about how loud the sound wave is. Okay, so loud, soft. So in these two things which I had just spoken now, the first thing had a larger amplitude. The first sound which I had produced had a larger amplitude, whereas the second sound which I had produced had a lesser amplitude. Okay, so amplitude tells you how loud or how less loud the sound is. Regarding one thing about frequency, you can very easily make out whether a male, suppose there's some person talking in a room, you cannot see the person, but you can make out, you can tell without even seeing the person whether the person is a male or a female. How? Based on the voice. Okay, males normally have a less frequency voice. We call it as a bass voice, B-A-S-S, bass voice. Okay, so males normally have a less frequency bass voice, whereas females have a slightly higher frequency voice. We call it as a treble voice. High frequency sounds are called treble sounds. Low frequency sounds are called as bass sounds. So females have a slightly higher frequency. So by listening to the pitch of the sound, the frequency of the sound, you can tell whether a male is talking or a female is talking. Okay. So this is about some few basics of sound and a few important parameters. Important thing is the frequency and the amplitude of sound. Now coming to the important part, what are ultrasonics? Okay. We human beings can hear any sound which has a frequency ranging from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, also called as 20 kilohertz. Okay, 20,000 is also called 20 kilohertz. So any sound having a frequency between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, we human beings can hear them. So such sounds are called as audible sounds. This range of frequency, 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, is called as an audible range of sound. Okay, we human beings can hear them. Now, any sound which has a frequency less than 20 hertz, we cannot hear them. They are called as infrasonic sound. Infra, what is the meaning of the word infra? Infra means less than. For example, we have infrared. Now, what is the meaning of infrared? It is a light having a frequency less than red color light. So similar way, infrasonic sound means the sound has a frequency less than the sonic range. What is the sonic range? Audible range, 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. So anything less than the audible range, that is anything less than 20 hertz, is called as infrasonic sound. We human beings cannot hear them, but there are some animals like elephants and other big animals which can generate and which can also hear infrasonic sounds. So that's about infrasonic. And now about an important thing, ultrasonic sound. What is ultrasonic? Ultrasonic sound is a sound having a frequency more than the sonic range, more than the audible range. So what is the maximum end of the audible range? It is 20,000 hertz. So sound having a frequency greater than 20,000 hertz is called as a ultrasonic sound. And this is what is the topic of discussion in this chapter. So we are talking about sounds which we cannot hear and have a frequency greater than 20,000 hertz. So That is about ultrasonic. So this figure here in brief explains what is the different sound ranges and what are they called. So you can see here, less than 20 hertz is called as infrasonic. 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz is called as the audible sound. We human beings can hear them. And above 20 kilohertz, 20,000 hertz is called as ultrasonics. Now, also interesting to remember is that ultrasonic sounds, though we human beings cannot hear them, there are some animals like bats and even dogs, okay, can hear these ultrasonic sounds. Okay, so they can produce them. Bats, for example, use this ultrasonic sound for their navigation. They send out a beam of ultrasonic sound, and if there's an obstacle in their path, the sound gets reflected from that, and based on that, they can make out whether there is some object. So even in darkness, bats can propagate very easily. They can fly through dark caves and all very easily by sending out ultrasonic sound waves and hearing the reflections from obstacles in their path. Okay, so this is about ultrasonics. So important definition to remember: ultrasonics are sound waves which have a frequency greater than 20,000 hertz. So we're going to start with this important part: production of ultrasonic waves. So we're going to see about two methods of producing ultrasonic waves in this chapter. Okay, there are many other methods also, but the important methods are the two ones: magnetostriction method and the piezoelectric method. So these two methods, in very much details, we're going to see in the next class. Okay, so I'll finish with this introduction of ultrasonics with this lecture. So production of ultrasonic waves, we are going to start in the next class.